Hello everybody, welcome to MG Decode videos. This video will talk about should we back up Office 365? All the features provided by Microsoft are good enough that we don't need any other backup solution. Let's first of all understand why do we really need to back up? And some of the very basic and very common ones are to prevent loss from corruption, accidental deletion, or it could be that any departing employee or malicious insider under the negative influence decides to be creative with the data, the company's data that they are not supposed to. But what if they delete some contractual, you know, email, some important documents, and you don't have a backup? So it's important to kind of think before you plan for your backup strategy. Other than that, could be the retention policy gaps, legal and compliance requirements. But let's see what Microsoft offers. So let's just quickly consider a scenario where you needed an email very badly. But apparently what happens is that you realize that email got deleted a few days back. You call your IT team and your IT team is not able to restore that. And you just get a simple and a humble apology from them. So in such scenarios, what you can do if you're using Microsoft Office 365, you can go back to your IT and ask them to check a couple of things. And I have tried to pin down all the steps, the initial ones that you will start doing once you are trying to recover a deleted email. The first and the foremost is you will first go ahead and check into your deleted item and search for your email in your deleted item. But let's say you are deleted. You deleted your email from your recycle bin as well, but you still need it. At that time, what you should do is go back to the administrator and ask them to open line MS Outlook. And let's just do it while we are talking about it. Let's open Outlook. When user delete an item, it remains in their deleted item. But if they have hard deleted it, they are not able to see that anymore. For that, they need to go into the recovery item. And from the recovery item, only an administrator can bring those emails and give it back to you. Or they can just restore those emails to their original location, like this. So what is really happening is, both the emails I delete from my deleted items as well, by mistake, of course. And there we go. So after it is hard deleted or shift deleted from my inbox and it's not in even in my deleted item folder, then it goes into the recovery item delete from this folder option here, and it stays here for a few days, around 14 days. If you have not messed around with the policies and all, it stays there for 14 days and it can extend up to 30 days also if you make changes. From here, your administrator can recover them back. Woohoo, we got our email back. But just consider a scenario that these emails have got purged by mistake from here also. Do we still have hope, or it's just end to all the hopes possible? Well, the answer that Microsoft offers is in e-discovery. You will not be able to get your email back into your original location, but you still have chances to recover a PST file if you remember details about your email. So for that, what you can do is to go here, open up admin option. In admin option, we'll look for e-discovery. But before that, before going into the e-discovery, we need to have certain permissions. We need two type of permissions, which is e-discovery administrator and e-discovery manager. And we need two permissions because we will preview the emails before we restore that. That's why we need e-discovery manager. Otherwise, only e-discovery administrator permission would suffice. But let's see how we can get those permissions. So go on to security. And of course, your administrator has to be with you with all the rights and permission to deal with this. And in security, once it opens up, go on to the permissions option. And here we go. In permissions, we'll look for e-discovery and we'll give our user, who our administrator, the rights there, the two rights that I've just mentioned. So first we'll look for e-discovery. Where is it? There we go. E-discovery manager. From here, we'll go and scroll down a bit. E-discovery manager is where we'll edit and add our user account. And e-discovery administrator, edit and add your user account. So once you click on edit, here you can edit and add users or members that you would like to add here. Okay, so now we have permissions and we are ready to move on to the next step. And the next step is we'll go on to the search and we'll look for our email that we have deleted. There we go. In the search, we'll go on to the content search and here I'll create a search query. Here, what I want, I remember the subject of my email because I purposely created email so that I don't forget. And the subject of my email was test email delete. I think not exactly like this, but somewhere close to that. So I'll say contains any of, and then I'll do the search and there we go. Okay. There we go. Specify location. I'll say modify, save and search. And this will be deleted email recovery. Search to look for email with specific subject. And let's see if it searches back my emails. I'll just skip through the video a bit once we have the result. Okay, voila, we got our emails back. So pretty much all of them. And if I would like to recover these emails, I can recover it from here also. But the only problem is it'll create a PST and I have to download the PST. I have to download this particular email and then later import it in my inbox, which is a bit of a complicated process really. What if I have by mistake deleted an entire folder with a lot of email inside it? It'll become really difficult for me to restore all the emails, or you know, when I have to look for the original options and keep putting them back where it belongs. So that's a bit of a downside, but at least I have my email without any specific backup options. So that's great. Okay, that's that then. But other than this, highly recommended options. Let's go back to our slide deck first and see where we have reached. Okay, so we have seen the recovery of deleted item from Outlook and from the recovery folder that your admin can get it back. Content search, we just saw how to do content search and with first how to get permissions and then how to do content search. And now let's do archive policy and retention policy. Yes, let's just do that. Okay, so let's just close this for now and we will go back to admins now. We have to go back to our admin and Exchange admin. Let's go for the classic view. I like classic view better. And here what we are going to do, as you can see from here, there are three or four steps that we will do. And what that will decide is it will create your own retention policy. It will be able to retain the emails that you will specify for a particular time slot, and then it will purge them as in when the retention ends. So what we and how we'll do it is first we'll enable archive mailboxes, then we'll create retention tag and retention policy. Creating archive mailboxes will leave the data there in the archive mailbox, so it's important that you retain it for a particular time frame and then keeps removing it. And then assign the mailbox to the retention policy. Looks to be straightforward. Let's go back. Okay, it's still opening up. So as we just saw, we will first go ahead and enable archive mailboxes. Archive mailboxes will leave all the mails in the archive folder, and from there we'll do the retention policy to clean them off as and when possible. Okay, so now here we'll go on to recipients and then mailboxes, and in mailboxes we'll enable archive first. So let's scroll down a bit. Here it is, enable archive. Let's enable it. Yes, please go ahead and enable archive. The next step is, once we have enabled the archive, it's all about retention tag, retention policy, and assigning to mailbox. We'll go on to compliance management. And in compliance management, we'll go on to the retention policies and retention tag. But before we go there, let's just quickly talk about e-discovery and hold. This option is also very good in terms of the compliance purposes. You can put in hold to the mailbox and the email will not be purged until you release the hold. And that is good for compliance and legal hold when certain email needs to stay in the inbox and with a feature that nobody can't even delete it. Other than that, let's go on to the retention tags first. Now here, there are a lot of options. You can see 1 week delete, 2 week delete. So here you can specify the kind of retention policy you would like to create. So we'll first, how it really happens is, we'll first create a retention tag. Then we'll go back to the retention policy. We'll associate those retention policies here and we'll make them the default MRM policy. And the default MRM policy as of now is this one. So these many tags are associated with this at this present, but in case you want your own specific, you would like to modify and make changes into the dates and into the timeline here, you can specify from here. So all you have to do for retention tag, click on the plus sign. And let's say I would like to create one retention policy for the default, as in an entire mailbox. So I'll specify the name of my retention policy, that it will 1 year delete. So delete after 1 year, delete and allow recovery, or permanently delete after 1 year. Whatever is in my inbox after 1 year, permanently delete that. Okay, 1 year delete latest, and then we'll save it. There we go. And 1 year delete latest here is here. I'll go on to the retention policy. I'll create a retention policy. Test retention policy. I'll add the tag that I have created. This one. And I'll say okay. And save. Thank you. I can have many more tags associated with this policy, which I think I should. In terms of what to do with your inbox folders, what to do with the personal emails and things like that. So just think through the kind of policy you want for your organization and then you can specify from here. Okay, so for assigning the mailboxes to my policy, we can also glance through the new Exchange Admin Center as well. And once you open new Exchange Admin Center, we'll again go back to mailboxes, where we configured our archive. I can also see, manage my mailbox policy, which all are defined right now. As you can see, all are the default one. So let's just modify. I don't want this. I want a new one because it's much more complicated, much more as per my requirements. All I have to do is to save and it'll make and modify all the mailbox retention as per the policy, new mailbox policy that I have associated with. Which I'm not gonna do right now because with this, as of now, only one tag I have associated, so it's going to be drastic for my inbox. Okay, coming back to our presentation. This is what we saw. Enable archive, creating retention tag and retention policy, and assign mailboxes to the retention policy. So this is this will be useful once you configure it. But what if you have not configured it? Then you should go for e-discovery option and explore it more. There are a few more options in there. Go ahead and explore them. It might come in handy. But then retention policy comes in handy once you exactly know the kind of data you want to retain for how long. Okay, now after talking about all these features, the simple question remains, is it good enough? So the answer to that is that it might not suffice completely and it cannot be a replacement to the backup policy. As you can also read from here, that backup and retention policies can only protect you from data loss, but in a limited way. And they cannot be replacement for a complete backup solution. Okay, now should I use a third party backup tools? Before we go into it, let me be very clear and specify it here that I'm not connected with third party vendors. So whatever I'll mention here, it's going to be just as per the experience. So if you're planning for a third party backup tool, then why the reasons why you really should plan for a proper backup policy and full-fledged backup solution is first one is to have better and efficient retention power options and moderate price available outside my MS. For specifying retention policies, creating DLs and all that particular details and going into that minute details, then after a point Microsoft starts charging you. And the cost can be much better refined for a third party tool. Also, for saving in terms of the repository, it gives you much more options to optimize your storage capacity as per your requirement. Also, point in time recovery is not available in this. For some people, it's very important that we need to have point in time recovery. At one point in time, the mail was. At once, the mail had certain information, and maybe after 2 days it got modified. But I need to go back, roll back to my earlier version. That doesn't happen in MS features, only third party tool can give you. Then, plan backup and data repository on different clouds to utilize cost optimization. I've already mentioned that. I think the most important is a rule that we always call it as a best practice rule for backup, which is three different types of copies of backup, not different types, but three copies of backup at any point in time in two different media, and one should be an offsite copy so that in case of any disaster, any problems, we will be able to recover our data. This best practice is not possible with MS features. And also, as you have seen, that it gives us PSTs. It's really difficult to keep working with a lot of PSTs if there is a folder that you need to restore. Though we have bulk operation, but it kind of becomes messy to work with each and every email. So that kind of a freedom you get much better in a third-party backup tool. All right, I hope these features will help you in finding the email you're looking for and also to help you plan better for your backup and backup retention policies and backup policies. I hope this was useful for you. Please don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon and look forward for my more videos. Thank you very much for listening.